That is the next difference of pressure transducer is this one. Okay, so now we have to develop the model of the variable capacitance differential pressure transducer. This one is one type of the pneumatic, you know, valve. Okay, this one is the example of the pneumatic valve. So we already have seen one example of the pneumatic valve that is very simple with the help of the stem and the diaphragm. How we develop the model, we have already seen. Okay, so the model is resembles with the first order system and the second order system. When we neglect the M by KGS, then it becomes the second order system, first order system, right? Now we are going to develop the model of the variable capacitance differential pressure transducer. It is a one type of again pneumatic valve. Okay, so as this picture is taken from the Stephen Paul's book. Okay, the reference is figure number 11.A.2. So this variable capacitance differential pressure transducer used in the very for the transmission of the pressure difference. Okay, so this one is the, as you can see here, this one is the def. Wait a minute. This one is the diaphragm. Okay, this one is the diaphragm, and when the pressure is applied, okay, then the pressure difference P1 minus P2. Okay. And that area is multiplied with that, right? And then becomes the delta force. And this force is acted on the diaphragm. And due to the diaphragm, the pressure is transmitted from one point to another point, right? So you can see here, the written is here, the transfer, a pressure signal is transferred through an isolating diaphragm. That diaphragm is here, right? And fill liquid in a sealed capillary system with a differential pressure sensing element. This one is the sensing element, right? And the pressure is transmitted through second isolating diaphragm and fill liquid to a sensing diaphragm. A reference pressure will balance the system. Okay, so what is the equation? So you know, P1 minus P2, whatever into area, okay, this becomes the force, and this force is acting on the mass, right? The sensing diaphragm, there's a mass of this one. So what is the mass? Mass is again weight upon W upon G. So this is your, becomes the total weight, and d2x by dt square is the acceleration, right? So this is a force as equals to, the force as equals to mass into acceleration. You can write the equation, okay? Now, you can see here also the P2. What is the P2? P1 is here. This is the pressure is inside this one. The P2 is coming from this side. The balancing equation is writing over where. So P2 is nothing but the Kx plus Cx dc by dt. What is this? This is due to the, this force is due to the spring and the, you know, the you can say the friction.
Capacitor.
Sorry.
No, sir, my friction. Oh.
Yes. So this is the, so this force you can write down P2 as equals to Kx plus Cx dc by dt, right? There is no mass in the this side. So you can write the equation, ultimate equation P2A and P1A. You can finally find out the equation. Write down this equation. Okay. And let's take that Laplace transform. And you can find out the final output displacement with respect to the pressure valve that we are going to apply it. So you are going to apply the pressure P1, and the displacement, final displacement is X. So you can find out the transfer function in the form of the second order system, right? Right. So this is the, you can develop the model like this one of the such type of system or such type of valve, right? Now come to the next point, that is we have studied that there are two different types of the valve, that is the air to close and air to open, right? And how it is decided, air to open, air to close, we already have seen when, okay, when this transmitting valve, that this pressure, that the pressure generated by this is when sent from the upper side, then it is called the air to close. Otherwise, when you supply this one from the bottom side, that is here, So it is called the air to open, right? So we already have discussed these things, air to close and air to open, right? So and we already have discussed the required pressure for the diaphragm is 3 to 15 psi and why it is required, we already cleared. Now it is a different, you know, architecture of the plug. That plug is connected with the stem, as you can see here. This one is the stem. Stem is connected with a spring for the balancing, and this is the plug. And this plug, based on the pressure, this plug is going to set into this system, right? This body. So how much air is going to pass, and what is the fluid, whatever the fluid or air is going to pass or not, that depends on the size of this plug, right? So these are the different plugs architecture you can see. Okay, this type of the characteristic, or this type of the characteristic, equal percentage hyperbolic quick opening, all these makes the different characteristic of the control one. How? You can see here with this graph. You can see here, when you use the linear square root of this type of architecture into the plug, then the characteristic of the curve is looking like the square root, and square root is represented by the 7. Or you can see here, this characteristic curve is resembles when you use the pressure into the displacement. Okay. So you, when you write out down the equation with for the displacement in terms of pressure, so you got the square root type of the equation, right? And this is the nonlinear, again becomes a nonlinear characteristic. Okay, when the linear curve, when such type, this second one, this is the second one, this is the one, third, and let's say four and fifth. Okay, so when you use the second type of the architecture into the plug, then you can see that the characteristic curve with the P into the relation between the P and X, okay, becomes, sorry, the X and P, the displacement, you can see here, the into the linear type. Okay, so for the linear type of the equation, we're going to develop the equation for the linear valve in a few minutes or a few seconds. So Fx is equal to, you can see here, X. This is a linear characteristic. You can see here for the square root. Okay, equal percentage is looking like this one. You will develop the model. And hyperbolic is like this one. Okay, so these are the different characteristics of the curve based on the plug size and architecture. Right? Any question? This is the X and this is the Fx, the flow capacity characteristic. Right? Any question?
Okay. Sir, it may say better konsa hoga, sir.
That depends on the requirement. अगर आप देखा जाए तो आप देखिए, ऐसा तो सबसे अच्छा लीनियर है, लेकिन बट बेस्ड ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट है ना, आप कोई भी यूज कर सकते हैं. मतलब कितना आपको प्लग में, आपको यहाँ पर किस तरीके, किस हिसाब से टाइट करना है, क्या फ्लो कराना है, कितना फ्लो कराना है, किस हिसाब से कराना है, दैट डिपेंड्स, राइट. और न्यूमेटिक में एक्चुअली ये जो आप देख रहे हैं, ये प्लग केवल न्यूमेटिक में यूज नहीं होता. एक्चुअली बहुत सारे स्पूल वाल्व, बहुत डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वाल्व है, जो मैंने आपको बताया था, बटरफ्लाई, दैट इज अ मैनुअल कंट्रोलर, यू कैन सी हियर, है ना. तो जहां जहां प्लग आएगा, ये देखिए प्लग है ग्लोब वाल्व का, तो प्लग का डिफरेंस जिस तरह से आएगा, उस तरीके से वो रिक्वायरमेंट पर डिपेंड करता है कि वो उसको किस तरीके से हमें बिहेव कराना है, किस तरह से क्लोज करना है. तो कोई अच्छा कोई खराब वाला यहाँ पर सिस्टम है नहीं कि कौन अच्छा है कोई खराब, राइट.
ओके सर,
स्टेम का पोजीशन कैसे मेजर कर रहे हैं?
स्टेम का पोजीशन कैसे मेजर कर रहे हैं, मतलब नहीं समझा.
मतलब सर जो ग्राफ है ना, स्टेम का पोजीशन, स्टेम पोजीशन वर्सेस वो फ्लो कैपेसिटी.
ओके, व्हेन यू सप्लाइज देन प्रेशर, व्हाट हैपन अल्टीमेट, व्हाट हैपन, दिस स्टेम इज गोइंग टू डिस्प्लेस फ्रॉम अपर साइड टू बॉटम साइड, एंड दिस प्लग इज गोइंग टू सेट इनटू दिस वन, राइट, यस और नो?
Yes, sir.
So the some displacement is going to happen in the stem or in the plug, ultimately, right? So we have taken this the point object, and whatever the displacement is going, we just measured final displacement. पहले कितना कितना था और कितना हुआ, उस डिस्प्लेसमेंट को मेजर कर लेंगे और उसी को हम लोग ट्रांसफर फंक्शन में और या यहां पर हम लोग लेंगे। क्लियर है एक्स में? ठीक है,
यस सर।
सो नाउ कम टू द पिक्चर, हाउ द लीनियर वाल्व ट्रांसफर फंक्शन और लीनियर वाल्व इक्वेशन इज गोइंग टू डेवलप। ओके, सो एज यू नो, एज यू कैन सी दैट द लीनियर वाल्व कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, लीनियर वाल्व मींस द characteristic is going to change of the function f with respect to x, that is the displacement, is constant, right? So you can write here df by dx is equals to alpha. You can see here, if this is the f, this is the x. So f with respect to x, f is changing with the x, is constant. So you can write here that the change in the df by dx is always a constant. So this is the alpha. Okay, and therefore, okay, so when you write the equation df by dx as equals to alpha, okay, that alpha is a constant. So now use the boundary condition and try to find out the equation limit. So you can see here, assuming that the valve is shut tight when the lift is at the lowest position. Okay, you can see here, when it is the lowest, in the lowest position, in the lowest position is this one. Okay, so this is tightly shut. Okay, so assuming such type of system, so we have f0 equal to x0, means this is open. Okay, and f1 is equals to x1, that is a closed, right? So we have taken the limit from fg x at the value of x0, at the value of x equal to 0, means the displacement is not happened, then function is totally open. Or f equal to 0, you can assume, where x equal to 1, it means it is displaced by some values. So that value is reflected in the your function, right? Yani totally closed. So from 0 to 1, you can say we have taken the integration limit or integrate this value. Okay, so you got alpha equals to 1. It means f is equals to what happened? Fx is equals to, when you put this value, becomes fx is equals to x. Right, so this is the equation. Next is the equal percentage. Equal percentage means the function is changing with respect to x, as the means x jitna change karega utna hi f change karega. Equal percentage valve, it means f is changing with the x in order to or maintain the value of f. Baat samajh aa raha hai? Hame kehna hai ki df by dx utna change karega jitna hamara f चेंज करेगा. ठीक है, तो इक्वल परसेंटेज है ये, इतना ही चेंज कर जितना ये चेंज करेगा, राइट? तो इक्वल परसेंटेज वाल्व का कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इस तरीके से हम लोग लेते हैं मैथमेटिकली, राइट? सो वी हैव टेकन वन कांस्टेंट, राइट? सो नाउ अगेन जस्ट इंटीग्रेट दिस वन, सो डीए बाय एफ बिकम्स एंड बीटा इनटू डीएक्स बिकम्स, फंक्शन हमने मान लिया एफ नॉट से एफ है 0 टू एक्स. ओके, सो जस्ट टू टेकन द log, okay, when you this one comes, log f ho jayega, dx by x is equals to nothing, the log x, right? So or yahan par beta x ho gaya. When you solve this one, f is equals to becomes f naught into e to the power beta x, when you eliminate the log term, when you take the limit f is equals to 1 x equal to 1, then it becomes beta. You can calculate the value of beta, right? Put this value instead of beta, right, and becomes this one as a f naught to the power 1 minus. How you can see here, when you put the value of beta in here, okay, becomes f naught e to the power x log kya 1 by f naught. Or chuki ye log hai, to characteristic of x into, you can use log y, so you can write here log y to the power x. Okay, so you can use this property. Right, since it is a 1 by f naught, then it becomes, when you take in the numerator side, then it becomes minus x, right? And log e to the power log this one, when you solve this one, it becomes f to the power minus x, right? So this is the f naught into f naught power minus x is equal to the f naught 1 minus x. So what happened? F is equals to, you can write finally, f naught to the power 1 minus x. Okay, so व्हाट इज दिस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, दिस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज इक्वल टू द एफ एच इक्वल टू, क्या हो जाएगा ये एक्स टू द पावर माइनस वन अल्फा टू द पावर एक्स माइनस वन. व्हाट इज अल्फा, अल्फा इज नथिंग बट द वन बाई एफ नॉट. वन बाई एफ नॉट करोगे ये आ जाएगा, ठीक है, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. वन बाई एफ नॉट करोगे वन माइनस एक्स का तो एक्स माइनस वन हो जाएगा और दिस इज द अल्फा. सो यू कैन राइट हियर अल्फा इज इक्वल टू अल्फा टू द पावर एक्स माइनस वन, राइट. सो दिस इज द फाइनल दिस वन. Okay, so these two linear valve characteristics you have to remember how this the different property is going to this architecture. How the mathematical model is going to develop for the different type of the architecture. Okay, we have seen here only the linear and the equal percentage. You can use any one. So you can refer the book Kufner, and you can find out. These topics have been taken from the Kufner book, right? So you can refer this book and for more elaboration. Now come to the valve sizing. So as you can see here, valve sizing means the size of valve is dependent on the capacity, right? So as you have seen, the Q, that is the flow rate. Flow rate is dependent on the pressure, whatever you are going to apply. That pressure is the P1 minus P2, as you can see, or pressure difference. ठीक है? और अब ये characteristic जो है, we have already generally the characteristic of the valve is resembles with the non-linearity. So we have taken here the square root characteristic, right? और उससे एक इक्वेशन बन के आया. दिस इक्वेशन इज अ स्टैंडर्ड इक्वेशन यूज्ड इन द कफनर बुक. ओके, द डेरिवेशन इज आल्सो गिवन. आई हैव नॉट टेकन द डेरिवेशन. सो दैट साइजिंग इज डिपेंड ऑन द सीवी एफएक्स एंड दिस वैल्यू, राइट. सो व्हाट इज द सीवी? सीवी इज द फैक्टर एसोसिएटेड विद द कैपेसिटी ऑफ द वाल. व्हाट इज द एसजी? एसजी इज द स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी. ओके, एंड व्हाट इज द एक्स? एक्स इज द स्टेम पोजिशन, दैट इज द एफएक्स, राइट. So based on this position, you can find out the value of fx, right? One means already we have seen fully open, okay. Zero means fully closed. So इस तरीके से आप इसको ले लेंगे. So one example is given: a valve with the CV rating 4.0 is used to throttle the flow of the glycerin for which SG is equal to given, determine the maximum flow rate. So you can find out the value, putting the this value in the equation, you can find out the flow rate, right? Now there are two terms, the sensitivity and the rangeability. What is sensitivity and rangeability? So sensitivity, the change in the output with respect to the displacement. Okay, it means sensitivity of the valve, which is simply the fractional change in the flow to the fractional change in the stem position. Okay, whatever the flow changes in the flow based on the change in the stem is known as the sensitivity. So what is the huge sensitivity means कितना ज्यादा वैल्यू जो आप देख रहे हैं स्टेम है ना, इस स्टेम के साथ जो प्लग लगा हुआ है, राइट. तो ये कितनी वैल्यू यहां से यहां तक कितना सेंसिटिव है, इसका मतलब है कि क्या इस माइनर चेंज की रीडिंग को ये उतने चेंज को पढ़ पा रहा है या नहीं पढ़ पा रहा है, डिस्प्लेसमेंट को वो ऑकरेंस उसमें आ रहा है कि नहीं आ रहा है, राइट. सो दिस इज द सेंसिटिविटी. ओके, जिस तरीके से आप कह सकते हैं कि पोटेंशियोमीटर में पीओटी में, राइट, आपने डिफाइन किया था क्या कि यहां से यहां तक सेकेंड स्प्रिंग में माइनर चेंज होने, जितना वो चेंज करने पर पोजीशन को जैक को, लेट से दिस इज जैक, ओके, जैक इज कनेक्टेड. सो दिस जैक अंटिल अनलेस इज नॉट मूविंग मूव टू द हेयर, देन द वोल्टेज इज नॉट चेंजिंग, राइट. सो मिनिमम पोजिशन कितना होगा एक्स का जो पोजिशन वोल्टेज को चेंज कर दे, सेम वही है, कितना डिस्प्लेसमेंट हो दैट चेंजेस द एफ वैल्यू. सो दैट इज द सेंसिटिविटी. नाउ कम टू द रेंजेबिलिटी. रेंजेबिलिटी इज द डिफाइंड एज द रेशियो ऑफ मैक्सिमम फ्लो टू द मिनिमम कंट्रोलेबल फ्लो ओवर द वाल्व कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फॉलोड. ओके, एफ मैक्स डिवाइडेड बाई द एफ मीन, मैक्सिमम वैल्यू डिवाइडेड बाई द मिनिमम वैल्यू, राइट. So these are the inherent, you can say here, the characteristic, the linear characteristic, the sensitivity, the constant, that is df by dx is alpha. You already have seen here in the first example. In the second example, इक्वल परसेंटेज के लिए आपने देखा है. सेकंड वन इज द एफ नॉट, दिस इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ द इक्वल परसेंटेज, राइट. सो दिस इज इंक्रीजिंग एंड दिस फॉर द स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ द क्यूब क्यू ओपनिंग इट इज डिक्रीजिंग, राइट. नाउ सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द न्यूमेटिक वाल्व. वन टॉपिक हैज बीन रिमेन्ड, दैट इज द योर हाइड्रोलिक वाल्व. ओके सो द टू टॉपिक हैज बीन रिमेन्ड टू सिलेबस. फर्स्ट इज योर आई थिंक हाइड्रोलिक वाल्व एंड सेकेंड वन इज योर द स्टेबिलिटी डिटेल स्टेबिलिटी एनालिसिस. सो बिफोर गोइंग टू द डिटेल ऑफ दैट आई वॉन्ट टू शो यू द सिलेबस. Yes, you can see here. We have covered this basic consideration. Okay, then we have seen the process characteristic, closed loop feedback controls, servo and regulator problem. We have already covered, right? The mathematical model of the liquid, thermal, mechanical, and chemical system. Right, degree of freedom we have covered, linearizing techniques we have covered, liquid level control in a tank is covered, right, distributed parameter, MIU and MO system is not covered. We will, okay, one example I will give. Then we have covered the first order, second order system, dynamics of the thermometer we already covered, non-intacting system, intacting system ne kar liya hai, mixing process kar liya hai, distillation column nahi kiya, right, so ek distillation column and MIU MO system. MIMO and the distillation column has been remained, right. Another thing is the controller characteristic. Control characteristic mein PI, PD, PID kar liya humne. Comparison of on-off, proportional, integral, derivative humne all and the combination of this already we have covered. The distal controller we have not covered. So, okay. And then the automatic control, the single and combined mode and closed loop, static error, velocity error. ESS we already have covered, hai na? ESS is equal to limit S into RS upon 1 plus GSHS, right? So based on that, the static velocity error can be calculated. Dynamic behavior of the feedback control system of the different modes, IAE, ISC, ITA criteria, tuning of the controller process action curve, it is already covered, right? Electronic pneumatic controller is covered. However, the hydraulic controller नहीं हुआ है अभी, उसको हम करवा देंगे. सिंगल मोड्स ऑफ कंपोजिट मोड्स पीआईडी पीआईडी मैंने करवा दिया है. लास्ट वन इज द कंट्रोल वाल्व टाइप्स. वी ऑलरेडी सीन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द कंट्रोल वाल्व इन द मैनुअल मैनुअल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक. सेकंड द सोलेनोइड हाइड्रोलिक, ये करवाना है हमें हाइड्रोलिक इलेक्ट्रो न्यूमेटिक. तो तीन चार टॉपिक बच गए, इलेक्ट्रो न्यूमेटिक, राइट, इलेक्ट्रो न्यूमेटिक वाल्व, देन द हाइड्रोलिक वाल्व, and then the solenoid, right, and stepper motor and E to P converter. So 1 2 3 4 5 and some MIMO system, MIMO and digital controller, right, nothing else has been remain. So this is the syllabus will be covered in coming 8 to 9 lecture. It is more than enough. ठीक है, तो उसके अकॉर्डिंग हम लोग करेंगे कि बचा स्टेबिलिटी. स्टेबिलिटी को हम इसको जल्दी से करा देंगे, नो प्रॉब्लम. ऑलरेडी यू हैव कवर्ड द स्टेबिलिटी, है ना. कुछ लोगों का क्लियरिटी नहीं था, देयरफॉर ओके. तो यू कैन सी फ्रॉम टुमारो, फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट वीक वी विल सी द हाइड्रोलिक वाल्व. ओके, तो ये दो तीन टॉपिक छोटे छोटे हैं, इसको हम लोग कवर कर लेते जल्दी जल्दी. ऑलरेडी कवर्ड, एज यू नो दैट द सिस्टम इज स्टेबल. व्हेन द सिस्टम इज स्टेबल, When you provide the for the input bounded, the output is bounded. When the input is bounded, the output should be bounded. then only you can see here the system is the stable. This is the one characteristic. In another characteristic, in the absence of input, Aditya ne ek baar mujhse question pucha tha, kya ho? Uska jawab hai. In the absence of input, when the input is not applied, then what happens? Then output tends towards zero. The output tends towards zero means, suppose this is a system 1 upon s plus 1. You have not applied any input. So, hum to keval isi ka dekhenge, e to the power minus t aayega. 1 upon s square plus 1. Main to isi ka dekhunga, sin t aayega. This is the system, right? So, when it is going towards, tend towards the zero, irrespective of the initial condition, the system is called asymptotic, asymptotic stability. Right? So, what it means? Mathematically, इसको हम कैसे define करेंगे? समझ में आ रहा है? और अगर it becomes the constant, this is a stability, if it is not tending towards zero, or it becomes a constant, the system is said to be the marginal stable. And if it not even the constant or not tending towards zero, it is tending toward the infinite. The output is not bounded. It means the system is unstable. There are three criteria, nothing else. So now, for the LTI system, for any LTI system, right? You know that the CS upon RS is nothing but the GS, right? So you can write CS as equals to GS into RS. So what is this? When you convert into the another form in the time domain, so it means it is the Laplace inverse of this one. Or what is the meaning of the Laplace inverse? That's the convolution. Nothing but the convolution. You can write it like this one, the equation. Okay. So this equation is nothing. When you take the absolute value on the both side, then it becomes mod of ct is equals to mod of integration of this value. This value. Okay. Now, okay. So since the absolute value, as you know that absolute value is not greater, since the absolute value of this integral is not greater than the integral of the absolute value of the integrand, and therefore you can write here c this value also. Mod of ct is less than equal to this individual integral of individual absolute value of the integral. Yes or no? So therefore you can write here for the stability condition, how it is not much very important for you, hana. So therefore you can write here for the input, for the BIBO input, you can see here the output is bounded, and also for the bounded input, you can see here the output is bounded because CT is less than this value. ये कभी ज्यादा हो गए नहीं, एंड देयरफॉर यू कैन से हियर द वैल्यू इज फाइनाइट एंड एरिया अंडर द एब्सोल्यूट वैल्यू कर्व फॉर द इंपल्स इज इवोल्यूटेड इक्वल टू टी जीरो टू इनफाइनाइट. हम टी कहां से क्या करेंगे, ये करते हैं और ये होता ही है. सो दिस वैल्यू इज आइदर शुड बी द इनफाइनाइट और शुड बी द जीरो.
सर ये पीस वाइज कंटीन्यूअस फंक्शन का भी डेफिनेशन होता है ना?
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. ओके सो अच्छा नेक्स्ट बात और. सो ये जो आप देख रहे हैं इनफाइनाइट टेंडिंग टुवर्ड्स जीरो और टेंडिंग टुवर्ड्स द कांस्टेंट टेंडिंग टुवर्ड्स द सॉरी गोइंग टुवर्ड्स द इनफाइनाइट. सो दिस ऑल डिपेंड्स. अब इसके चलते क्या है कि द लोकेशन ऑफ मेनी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स हैव नॉट क्लियर दिस कांसेप्ट, है ना? तो इसको क्लियर करना जरूरी है. डिपेंड्स ऑन दिस वैल्यू, depend on this characteristic, you can see the position of the poles changes. Depends on this, not due to the position of the poles, this value changes. ऐसा नहीं है. फिर से उल्टा बोल रहा हूं मैं बोल रहा हूं कि ये जो करेक्ट BIBO के चलते जो पोजिशन है वाल्व का, यू कैन से हियर द पोल्स ऑफ द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन विल डिसाइड द नेचर ऑफ द स्टेबिलिटी. और यू कैन सी ईस्ट का पोजीशन अपने आप कुछ ऐसा आएगा और उसके चलते कह सकते हैं कि सिस्टम स्टेबल है या अनस्टेबल, राइट? ओके सो नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट इफ देयर आर नॉन रिप्टेड रूट्स ऑन द इमेजिनरी एक्सिस नॉन रिप्टेड रूट्स ऑन द इमेजिनरी एक्सिस द रिस्पॉन्स ऑसिलेट्स मीन्स लाइक दिस वन. ये कैसे हुआ बहुत लोगों से पूछा था वाइवा में किसे बहुत कम लोगों ने बताया. सो व्हाट इज दिस दिस द पोल लोकेशन द पोल लोकेशन इज एस इक्वल्स टू जे एंड एस इक्वल्स टू माइनस जे एंड देयरफॉर यू कैन राइट द इक्वेशन फॉर दिस वन अपॉन एस प्लस जे एंड वन अपॉन एस माइनस जे फॉर दिस वैल्यू दिस वन फॉर दिस वैल्यू दिस वन सो दिस इज व्हाट व्हाट इज दिस इज एस स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर. When you multiply with the a, then this equation becomes like this, and you can. This is nothing but the sinusoidal response. So therefore, it is said that if it is the one upon a sin a t. So therefore, you can see here. Say you can conclude if there are non-ripped roots of the on the non-imaginary axis, the response will oscillate, and obviously this will oscillate because this is a sinusoidal. If there are ripped roots on the imaginary axis, means like this one, the double roots plus j minus j, s equals to j j, s equals to minus j, there are four roots. Then what happened? Then the response oscillates with increasing amplitude. It means you can see here. See when single pole minus plus j. And minus j, then this such type of response will come. However, I have not shown. Okay, no problem. So when this such type of second type of the curve, that is the repeated roots on the imaginary axis will come. Then this location you can write. So the transfer function becomes s plus j, s plus j, s minus j, right? S minus j. So what it means? It means you can write s square plus a square whole square. Or what is this? A se multiply kar diya jaye. So kya ban jayega? 1 upon a t into sin a t. Or 1 upon t sin a t means this is the t sin a t. So this is the increasing amplitude. The response is oscillating. With increasing amplitude. I think it is clear. Any doubt? Hai kuch problem? Main phir puchunga to mujhe jawab dete ho. Abhi to puchte nahi ho. Abhi aap puchenge nahi. Aur jab main puchunga to phir aap jawab dete ho. Please. Any doubt? So nahi nahi aadhe log ko to 90% log is not interested in listening to lecture. Okay, come to the next important part, that is your single root position. Let's say single root is at the origin, then the output is a constant amplitude. Output is a constant amplitude means UT will come. 1 upon S means UT. And what is the output of UT? It is a constant. And therefore, it is nothing but the marginal stimulus. If they are ripped root at the origin, let's say double pole is at the origin, 1 upon s square, 1 upon s into 1 upon s. S equals to 0, s equals to 0. Two pole hai hamare paas. Kahan par hai? 1 upon s pe, 1 upon s pe. To kya ho gaya? 1 upon s square, 1 upon s square means t. T means the output is increasing without bound. This is not bounded. And therefore it is the unstable. So you can see s equals to minus a 1 upon s plus a. E ho gaya. Let's say this is the plus j. This is the plus j and minus j. And let's say this is the position is minus b. Or yes, minus b. Okay. So aap isko kya likhenge? Minus b plus j and minus b minus j. When you solve s minus b plus j and s minus b. Plus b ho jayega na, plus b minus j. So you can solve it, and when you solve, then you got e to the power minus t sine omega t type function. So this is the decreasing function with the right. Okay, so ye aapka aa jayega. when at the origin, you can see here the constant value will come, and this is the marginal estimate. Okay, we have already covered this one. When the pole is lifting towards the right side, then you can see 1 upon s minus a e to the power at is like this one. Okay, position is a. So s is equals to a means 1 upon s minus a, right? e to the power at. You can also calculate as e to the power at ho jayega, aur saath mein sin at. So it will increasing function. e to the power at is like this one, and sin is increasing. Right? So this is a summary. The system is bounded. For the bounded input, the output is the bounded and therefore is stable. Otherwise, if the system is not bounded, unbounded, that is, if the characteristic is infinite, is equal to infinite, that is unstable. Okay. So 1 upon s, last point, and that's the important normal difference of the stability. Remember, always remember, a pole is the origin. Pole is at single pole. I'm talking about the single pole. When the single pole is here, then this is nothing but the 1 upon s. And 1 upon s, nothing but the integrator. Okay. So pole at the origin. When you are adding the pole at the origin, it means you are integrating. You are making the system integrator. You are adding one integrator into the system. Next, a pair of conjugate poles on the imaginary axis correspond to sinusoidal oscillator. When you want to make the system oscillator, sinusoidal oscillator type of the system or response, then try to add the conjugate poles on the imaginary axis. Imaginary axis pe aapko kya karna hoga? You have to add the pole at the conjugate axis or the imaginary axis. Single pole. Remember, single pole. Both the integrator and sinusoidal oscillator are useful device. As you know, the response to both the cases is bounded unless the input has pole matching one of the system poles at the conjugate axis. Right? Acha. Next. So, depending on the final response, such a system may be treated as stable or acceptable or non-acceptable. This system are also called a marginally oscillator. Means 1 upon s or a sinusoidal oscillator is also called as a marginally stable or limiting stable system. Why? Because this gives us bounded value. Okay, or you can see this is the bounded. This is the bounded between the plus 1 minus 1, plus V minus V. Okay, and therefore it is the marginal stable or the limited stable system. Okay. Now come to the absolute and the relative stability. So for the relative stability, means let's say there are two systems. One system is, let's say, 1 upon s plus 1, and another system is 1 upon s plus 2. So you can compare both the systems are stable, because both the poles for the s plus 1 and s minus s plus 2, one pole is located at s equals to minus 1, and another pole is located for the second system s equals to minus 2. Both are the stable. But which one is the more stable? How can you comment? So the term comes with the picture in the relative stability. Obviously, 1 upon s plus 2 is more stable than the 1 upon s plus 1. Okay? And then now for the relative stability, we have to apply the different techniques. That is, the one of the technique is the Rao-Thurmes. We will see the one example. So necessary is condition based on the roots of the characteristic equation, we will try to find out the stability. Okay, so the characteristic equation of the nth order is given by like this one, right? And the root of this polynomial equation, whatever it will give, that will provide the roots, right? So the in the Rao-Thurmes criteria, all the coefficient of the characteristic equation, this is the a0, a1, a2, whatever up to the an, should the real and have the same sign. Same sign means either should all the values are positive or all the values should be negative. So you can say that it should be the positive. If you thought all the values are negative, it means just to transfer this becomes zero, but becomes positive, right? So you can say either the same sign or the same, the positive, all the values, all the coefficients should be the positive. Okay. No, none of the coefficients should be zero. Matlab, a naught, let's say a naught we have written, let's say 3s cube plus s square plus 1. So is the system is stable? No. Why? Because one term is missing, that is the 3s square plus s square plus s term. S term is missing. ठीक है, therefore none of the coefficients will be zero. तो coefficient इसका coefficient क्या था यहाँ पर zero है, and therefore system is missing. तो all the coefficients will be present. All the coefficients will be present. Okay. However, this condition are necessary but not the sufficient because it is a quite depending on the nature. Okay. तो हम लोग देखेंगे इसको. तो यहाँ पर second, third order के लिए solve करना तो थोड़ा सा आसान है. You can see the position. You can see the position of the poles, but for the higher order system, you are not able to find out the poles. Okay, so क्या करेंगे हम लोग? उसके लिए आपको Routh array stability आपको करना होगा, ठीक है? तो as you know, क्या करते हैं इसमें? Anyone can tell me how the Routh array will work?
कोफिशिएंट्स लिख लेते हैं, एक टेबल बना लेते हैं और मतलब क्रॉस मल्टीप्लिकेशन कर करके लाइक a नॉट a3 माइनस a1 a2 मतलब a1 a2 माइनस a2.
ठीक है, ठीक है. तो राउथ एरे फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट, इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास आई विल डिस्कस द राउथ एरे एंड देन द रूट लोकस, द टू टेक्निक्स आई विल डिस्कस एंड देन वी विल मूव टू द रिमेनिंग पोर्शन, राइट? सो ओके.